Hi, this is Elizabeth, one of the co-hosts of Beauties and Headcanons. Thanks for listening to the following broadcast on Public House Media.
This is Kim Meyer, the host of Choose to Rise here on Public House Media. Thanks for listening to the following broadcast on Public House Media. Once you're done with this episode, I hope you'll come check out my show, Choose to Rise, where we talk about living with positive mindsets, how to increase our confidence, building our faith, and living out our life on purpose. A new show comes out via podcast every Monday, Wednesday, Friday. And if you want to catch the episode live instead, stop by Public House Media around 6:45 Central Standard Time, Monday, Wednesday, Friday as well. Don't forget to subscribe on iTunes so you'll never miss an episode of Choose to Rise. Thanks again for checking out the following broadcast on Public House Media.
How's it going, everybody? This is Coffee with Keith and Katie. She's behind the camera. And we are on Public House Media. Thank you so much for joining us once again on this beautiful Monday night that we're having. It was negative 25 today at one point, I think. Beautiful day outside. Anyways, Katie's behind the camera, and I am on this side of the camera because I'm going to be showing off my brand new coffee maker machine. It's not the most craziest thing in the world. It's a simple Mr. Coffee machine. Looks just like that, but it's different than your normal 12-ounce pot of coffee. It has it's an espresso machine, and you can make espresso drinks, you can make lattes, you can make cappuccinos, all with this little guy, and it has the steaming rod, too, so you can...
Hi, David! Thanks for watching!
David, thanks for watching. Katie's gonna have to give me, let me know who's watching, so David, thanks so much for watching. As always, if you're just joining us, got my new coffee maker, and we're going to make lattes today, and we'll see if the caramel latte that I make can match up to the caramel latte that Starbucks makes, and the big judge on that one will be Katie to see if it passes her palate. It should be pretty close. We have the Starbucks
caramel.
Your face caramel
is a coffee machine, so. David says.
What's that?
Your face is a coffee machine.
Face is a coffee machine, David? Why are you coming at me so hard today, David? Give me a break.
Hi.
I appreciate it.
So they can see what you're doing?
Yeah, come on over here. But first, got to give a shout out before I forget to David Cinco. Last week, we showcased a Melitta coffee. If you want to have the... We have the filters right here. We have the pods right there. We showcased them last week because they are now officially the new coffee sponsor of Manchester United. And I was saying last week, it's great. It was the first time I ever heard of a sports club of any kind having an official coffee sponsor. But coincidentally, this guy, David, who I know, his name is David Cinco. And David Cinco is the smartest person I know when it comes to sports facts and figures. I used to think I was pretty good at it. When I was in high school, it was before everybody had Google on their phone. People need to know some sort of random sports fact, or if they needed somebody to settle a bet for them about a sports question, my friends and other people, they'd come to me because I just happened to know just that stuff because I knew it because my dad always knew it and my brother always knew it. But David Cinco blows anybody I've ever known, including my dad, much as it pains me to say it.
Whoa.
Out of the water. Oh, it's not even close, this guy. I know David from doing a lot of things with Under Armour. For those of you that have known me for a while, I've done a lot of things with Under Armour in the past, and I've known him from doing things that way. I just saw him this weekend, as a matter of fact, in L.A. That was fun. But anyways, he says, Keith, Manchester United, in fact, not the first soccer club to have a coffee sponsor. And he said the Brisbane Roar, the A-League, an A-League team in Australia, had the coffee club company as their jersey sponsor from 2007 to 2015. I didn't know that. So he hit me up on that message last week right after the show. And so I see him in L.A. this past week and I said, David, did you just know that? or did you look it up? Did you really have to research for it? And he said, honestly, I just knew it. He said he just knew it. He said, this is how we knew it. Because he played as that team in FIFA.
That's awesome.
And I don't know. But anyway, but David, had to give you a shout out again. Everybody, David Cinco, we call him Stats. Somebody gave him the nickname Stats a couple years ago during the Under Armour game because he was just showing off how smart he was with all the random sports facts. So, David Stats Cinco got it done for us. He's our new fact checker now for Coffee with Keith and Katie.
Official stat checker of Coffee with Keith and Katie.
Anyways.
And Mr. Fuzzy Face.
And Mr. Fuzzy Face.
Who is right. On the counter was a very naughty kitty.
So.
All right, Keith.
So I'm measuring the water out here. Gonna get two servings of espresso.
Very important.
And enough to steam the milk. Pour that in there.
It has to be enough to brew the coffee and to steam the milk.
Correct. And this.
Not separate reservoirs.
Right, and this little handy dandy guy shows you how many. This is for two servings of espresso and then also for steam. Now it's going to take a cold cup of milk, approximately 4 ounces of milk, 2 minutes to steam the milk up to 165 degrees. So we got, of course, if we're gonna compare it to Starbucks, we gotta do it all Starbucks. So we got Starbucks espresso, Starbucks caramel syrup, and I got a ground at Starbucks as well, so we could get the ground consistency just right for their espresso beans. So we're doing it as official as we possibly can. Now I'm lacking a few of the official. For the official tools that one usually has to make espresso, I don't have the tapper to really tap it down, so I just kind of gotta.
And that's what we learned from Tyler.
Do it like this. If you guys want to go back, watch a great episode of Coffee with Keith and Katie. Go back and watch Tyler Overlay teach us how to make cafecito. He had one of these fancy machines as well, and it was a great episode. Tyler, as a matter of fact, has moved to Atlanta, so I can't go back over to Tyler's place and get that crazy good coffee anymore, because now he's in Atlanta.
Maybe he can still make coffee in Atlanta, though. I'm just going to have to go to Atlanta
to get it. All right, so it's not the hardest tap down as possible, but there you go. Got the coffee in there. Gonna bring this right here. Gonna lock it into place. Put the four cup right there. All right. And we froth the milk first. You froth the milk first. And as you, when you're letting that settle, once you're done steaming it, then you get your espresso shot ready. I don't have anything metal. Now, the thing that's disappointing about this is that I don't have a frothing pitcher. It's usually a metal or ceramic. I have a bunch of ceramic coffee mugs, but this one has a little spout, which will make it easier to pour it in there. So, gonna have to end up using this today. Gonna put 8 ounces in there.
That's 2%.
8 ounces, you're right. I was gonna.
Except the skim was not.
This, it depends on what kind of head of foam you get on there. That depends on what kind of milk you use. Whole milk will we'll get a good head, but it'll, it's obviously not as, it's a little less healthy than 2%. 2% makes it pretty good. Smaller bubbles, so it still gives you a good head of foam, but, you know, easy to control if you're trying to make a cute little design. Mm-hmm. I'm going to try to do that today. The best I've ever been able to do is just a little circle.
And it was a lovely circle.
It was a great circle. It was a beautiful circle. It was the best, one of the best circles anybody's ever made.
Yeah.
All right. So it's going to take a minute for that to warm up. So I turned it on, as you can tell. Steam is warming up there. As we're waiting for that to get ready, we're going to put 2 tablespoons of this caramel syrup.
Mm, smells good.
In the bottom. There's 1. And there's 2. And it doesn't really matter how much you put in, how much you don't put in. It strictly depends on how you want your coffee to taste. I know Katie's going to want more of that caramel flavoring in there, so we put 2 tablespoons. And I know she doesn't like as strong as coffee flavor, so we went heavy on the caramel syrup, and we went a little more on the milk. So I know how Katie likes her coffee.
Aww.
So we're waiting for it to start. You can start hearing it work a little bit. Now again, this is going to take, we have about 8 ounces of coffee in here. And
I can hear it.
Even Katie can hear it.
I can hear it.
We have about 8 ounces of coffee in here, and the heat is going to escape it easier in this because it's plastic and there's a wider open top. So it might take a couple minutes for this milk to get completely done. I'm gonna be honest. This is only my 3rd time trying to make a latte at home. So if it doesn't go exactly right,
too bad, Greg.
That's
can't
my disclaimer.
See this. Maybe he can hear it though.
Is that what David? That what David said?
Yeah.
Maybe it's fortunate that Greg can't see this, depending on how it turns out. Maybe it's fortunate that Greg's not going to be able to see this happen.
Yeah.
So, still waiting for it to start going. There we go. Start hearing it now. Getting a little stronger. There we go. So you can already see the foam starting to form. Now, because this is a different kind of mug that I'm using, it's not real official. You're supposed to kind of work the frothing spout around the mug, but really can't do that the best with this thing. And you're supposed to allow, obviously, enough room for the milk to expand with the foam. And I'm keeping my hand on the bottom there so I can feel how warm it's getting. Again, 4 ounces of coffee, 4 ounces of milk will take approximately 2 minutes. I have 8 ounces, maybe it'll take 3. I can start feeling it get a little warm. Again, the whole, with the 2% milk, the bubbles are supposed to be a lot finer, and that's what we're getting right now. The bubbles are a lot smaller. I used skim milk a while back, and the foam got really, like, really high, really fast. Yeah. All right, so you can definitely start to feel it get warm. I can't really move it around that well. But it's coming together nicely. this. I got this last Monday, right before we did our show. I got this. All right, so that's feeling pretty warm now. So I'm gonna turn that off.
Is it about the temperature more than the bubbles?
It's about the temperature more than the bubbles. The bubbles are about where we need it to be, and of course,
bubbles are a bonus.
You're done. Gotta wipe it off so it doesn't get all gross.
That Starbucks, kid.
Oh, I must be doing a real official job then.
Good job.
All right, and now
I leaned in the sink.
You're gonna turn it.
I'm
gonna turn it right back on for the espresso. There we go. We got that brewing. We're gonna wait for that to fill up, then we're gonna pour that guy in here. I'm gonna pour this on top of that, and hopefully we'll get something resembling a latte. Mr. Fuzzy Face is not sure what's happening right now. He's a little worried. All right, that's seems to be about it. Give it another second or two. All we're getting is...
smells good. Smell it, David?
All right. Turn that off. Pour that in there. All right, now, here's a moment we've been waiting for. See how I can...
I thought this was going to be 2 cups.
Just making one. I'm not good enough to make 2 cups and try to do... So we're making one and we're sharing it.
Okay.
All right, ready?
Yeah.
All right, so you start out high. Mm-hmm. Let it all mix in there, and then once you get, and you go in low, and then you leave it there, and then. And that's a heart.
It is a heart. I can see it.
I don't know if you can really see it.
I can tell.
So, there you go.
I can tell. It's a heart. Aww. That's so sweet.
You know what? We'll try to make it look real fancy.
Boy.
Try to dress it up a little bit. If I can find the toothpicks.
The toothpicks are over here.
Oh, there
they are, right there. Boom. I'm not entirely sure what he's doing with toothpicks. I haven't seen the
barista
that Starbucks used toothpicks. Oh, I think that's cheating.
That's not cheating. I'll tell you what's cheating. There we go.
Oh, that's very nice.
How's that?
Oh, that's so nice.
And we'll go... It's the arrow.
I can tell.
Made out of love on Coffee with Keith and Katie. Oh. Mind if I try it? No, you have to try it
no,
first.
No, you try it first.
I have to try it first? Okay.
I'm running the camera.
Tastes like a caramel latte.
Yeah?
Yeah, I think it tastes like a caramel latte. All right. So, I'm going to put that right there for Mr. Fuzzy Face to try. Nah, just kidding. All right, Katie's turn.
Boy, it's so pretty. I don't want to ruin it. Very coffee-ish.
How'd I do? You can taste the caramel, right? Do you have to mix it?
I can tell it's the caramel latte.
Do you have to mix it with a spoon?
Maybe.
All right. I'll let you mix it with a spoon.
We saw the heart and it was beautiful.
All right. What do you think?
Pretty good stuff.
Pretty good?
Pretty good.
All right, so...
It's tough to get through the foam. And once you get down there, it feels like it's a darker roast than we usually get.
All right, so rating it from 1 to 10, 10 being the closest to Starbucks.
And 1 being not close to Starbucks at all, what would you say? How would you say I did?
I would say a 7.
7? Okay.
Yeah. A C. A C for like my third time doing it, that's not too bad,
yeah,
right?
Okay. That's very good.
And I even got a kind of a heart out of it.
How would you rate yourself?
I would think it's a pretty good latte. I'd say 7's about accurate. I'll agree with you on that.
You want to try some fuzz? You can't splash on the counter.
Just fuzzy face, get off the counter.
What will people say about how we live?
Oh my god.
This is not how we behave.
That's disgusting.
Get off the counter.
My elbow's wet.
All right.
What? I think that's about it. This has been Coffee with Keith.
And Katie on Public House Media.
Everybody, thank you so much for joining us for another episode. Hope you enjoyed my little tutorial on how to make a latte. And we'll get better as the shows go on. Again, one more shout out to David Stats Cinco for providing us with a tidbit. And David, thank you so much again for watching live as you always do. More Coffee with Keith and Katie to come next week. Monday, 7 p.m., as always. Where?
Who knows?
Public House Media.
Oh.
You're like, oh, the physical location. Who knows? But we're always going to be on Public House Media. Everybody have a great week, and we will see you next week for more Coffee with Keith and Katie.